This week it was with a text, church. Lord said, "What, son, I made you a new threshing instrument. That's, you're not sending that text, are you?" I said, "Lord, well, no, I sure am not, because it's got to be truth and mercy, because, well, your word says that." And that's what he said. You said that's what you're going to do, so I guess that means that I got to do. Yeah, God will get you. He knows how to get you. It's with our words, church. When Moses, it says he went before the congregation. He said, it says, if you read in Numbers, it says he heard the voice from the mercy seat speaking. Faith has a voice. Guess what? So does mercy, church. That mercy seat got a voice. You know what it says? I love you. I forgive you. I don't like this text right now. Let me sharpen up my instrument here. Let me give truth and let me give mercy. Let that be my response. How else are you going to eat up them mountains and hills? By raging? Why do the heathen rage? Because they don't control their emotions. That's why. Because they let their emotions live their life for them. They let their emotions speak for them. No, just the pastor. Praise the Lord. These are the best threshing instruments in the world. Jesus. Truth, mercy. Mercy's got a voice. It's also got a name. It's Phil. It's Felicia. It's Randy. It's Carlos. It's Janice. It's Jim. It's Mike. Mercy got a voice? Does mercy? It's kind of what we came out of. Yeah. Yes, mercy has a voice. Yeah, that's how we take down these mountains, and I love it. Then what happens? Thou shalt fan them. The wind shall carry them away, and the whirlwind will scatter them. And thou shalt rejoice in the Lord, and shall glory in the Holy One of Israel. You see, the minute I say, no, my emotions aren't going to speak, what's going to speak? Truth and mercy is going to speak. Now what happens? God says, okay, you just destroyed the enemy. I'm going to, listen, we can't, does anyone control the wind in here? No. God controls the wind. Whether it's a breeze or whether it's a strong wind, whatever the breeze, how, the depends on the size of the mountain, he'll use the breeze necessary to remove the mountain. Can I get an amen? Amen. Didn't he dry up the Red Sea? That was a big Red Sea, church. He brought the right exact amount of wind he needed to dry it up. It's amazing how God can do that. Maybe he really is God. Maybe he really is the first and the last. Maybe all of the gods are just nothing but a silly joke. Maybe. But I love it. When did the wind come? It came after my response. You see, God's not going to clean up the mess and now we get, okay, now let me talk to you about Jesus. No. In the mess, you still declare love and mercy. Yeah, but pastor, they're spitting on me. I know, you gotta wipe it off and then it's still love and mercy. That's the threshing instrument. Now that you've done that, now God comes in and then he'll sweep it away. God's a God of order, church. He's not gonna sweep it away and then you get to talk. God, please remove the mess and then I'll step in and have something to say about this. Yeah, he can get any joker to do that. The world's full of them. And usually me on a bad day. I'll put that joke outfit on. Nope, the wind comes after our response. Just be the threshing machine. Just speak truth and mercy, and then God will do it. Verse 18, I will, again, this is God, open rivers in high places and fountains in the midst of the valleys, and I will make the wilderness as a pool of water and the dry land springs of water. Who will? God. Where's the river? It's in a high place, church. We're not talking about the actual rivers of the earth, because again, it's an oxymoron. The rivers, they gotta flow down from the mountains, right? Not this one. This one flows up. It's the high places. And Psalm says that God is a river. Is there any higher place than you, God? No, Phil, there is no higher place than me. Maybe that's the place he's talking about. Call me crazy. And what does his river flow as? It can only be peace, church. The Bible says that. Peace like a river. Peace. Why do we do all this? Why am I the threshing instrument? Why do I chomp up the mountains and the hills? Listen, I'm just trying to get to the river of peace. If you let those stupid mountains and hills control your life, you worship your stupid idols, you're never going to get to peace, man. You're going to have the crazy thoughts up here, and you're never going to have peace, man. The unrighteous thoughts. It's just when I don't think right of myself and I don't think right of my brothers and sisters. Because I look into their lives and I look at their actions, and God's like, you ain't never going to find peace looking at that, man. You need the open river from the high place. Didn't Jesus also say that? Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Does living water flow from you? If it does, you look for peace in your life. Not war, not a courtroom, church. That's why the heathen go to court. They don't have a river of peace. They'd rather fight. Because after all, we know we're right. No, just a pastor. God don't want you to be right. He just wants you to be a river of peace. He's not concerned with all that. There's way too much here, but let's close this out because I can go on forever. 27. The first shall say to Zion, behold, behold them. I will give to Jerusalem one that bringeth good tidings. Here's the last I will. God will do this. Who is that? It's Jesus Christ, church. Bringing good tidings. Say something good. Chew up the mountains. Say something good. It's really that simple, church. Who does this, though? God does it. God does it. But we got to match his 12. That's the divine government in Revelation talks about. There's 24. If I add my 12 with his 12, then don't I get the will of the Father? Not my will, but yours be done. I just told you the will of God. There's 12 of them. It ends with a river of peace, church. If your situation doesn't end with a river of peace, pick a different path. My 12 matches his 12. Will somebody say, I will? Amen. It starts with the first three. Listen, I can't remember all 12. I can't. I mean, I guess I could, but I don't right now. But I remember the first three, and I remember the last one. The first thing he's got to do, strength. I will strengthen somebody. How? With faith. Tell them about God. Give them faith. Amen? I'll help them. Will we help them? I will. Lord, I will help them. Even though I got to chew up some stuff, I can chew it up and help them at the same time, church. I can still love them and forgive them and show mercy and still help them at the same time. Amen? And then if they fall, because we're likely going to fall, I knew they were going to fall. I will help them up. I will become the river of peace. I will. I mean, God will, church. He can, he will. By the way, there's like, I started researching, there's like thousands of he will, he can, he does, he is, he will. So yes, he can, yes, he will. But again, perfect that which concerns us. And in the process, I said, Lord, he did that to me this week. I mean, it was just so obvious. I'm like, Lord, I will. I mean, he got me good, man. Got me good, man. Got me to go quiet first because, man, I was praying up a storm. I was praying up a good one, church. Oh, I can pray. Probably not as good as my pop, but I can pray. Man, he shut that prayer down so fast. Mine was like, whoop. I guess I got nothing to say. That's okay too, church. I sat there for like 15 minutes in dead silence in my house. Say a word. And he just overwhelmed me, man. Got me to the point where I said, Lord, that's me. I will do that. I'll be that threshing instrument for you. He just showed me so many things. And then he showed me that I actually did. And I was like, oh, man, thank you. He showed me I got it right. I asked the worship team if they'll come. God's a good God, man. Yeah, the truth is, he's got it all, does it all. All he wants is first, really, most of the time, just be silent, man. And then he'll take us by the hand. He'll show us the way, amen. He'll guide us. Why don't you stand while we close out?